Hi, this video is perfect for you if you want to work on your dancing skills, on putting simple moves and dance elements together into a fluent pole choreography. If you're a beginner and you already have some experience with basic spins, climbing and pole sits, but you're overwhelmed by upside down tricks, then this is the right level for you. If you're more advanced and you can do crazy tricks on the pole, but you want to improve your coordination, your transitions and your choreographing skills, then this video will be helpful also for you. And also, if you're a teacher and you're looking for new ideas for your own classes, feel free to use this choreography or parts of it and teach it to your students. This is a quick video guide rather than a detailed tutorial. It doesn't break down every move and every transition of the choreography, but you're going to find at the beginning of this video key exercises and progressions for the most challenging parts of the choreo. Plus, you'll find a list with the names of the moves. I also prepared for you a new warm-up video, which is for free, and you can get it on thepoledancer.com/flow-warm-up. It's an updated edition of the flow warm-up, which you've probably seen in my previous tutorials. Now it's even easier to follow along. Besides that, it will warm up your muscles. Its main focus is on fluidity and making your movements more soft, elegant, and dance-like. Warm up your hips in advance. Circle with each leg 10 times to the back and 10 times to the front. Step 1, lift your leg and lower your body. Push your hips out and pull the knee towards your shoulder. Repeat 10 times. Step 2, keep your knee up, pull belly in and kick towards the pole. Bend and straighten your leg for 5 times. Step 3, put it all together and draw a complete circle with your leg. The lower your body and the more your pelvis is tucked in, the bigger the circle will appear. Follow the leg movement with your gaze. This could take some practice. Also, your circle might look different than mine, depending on your hip flexor and hamstring flexibility. Repeat these steps with the other leg. In the sun wheel, the legs are in a 90 degrees attitude position. The front leg is turned out, knee pointing to the side and heel facing the ceiling. Use your glutes and your abs to hold the leg high. Keep your hand on your hips and swing 10 times to the front. Hold your leg up for another 10 seconds. The back leg is also turned out, knee and heel pointing to the side. Really squeeze your butt cheeks together. Swing 10 times. Keep the hips facing forward, don't open them to the side. Hold for another 10 seconds. Repeat with the other leg. You should slowly start feeling the exact muscles that support your legs.
During the spin, the ankle of the front leg is hooked on the pole and the other leg is to the back. Both legs are bent in approximately 90 degrees angle. Try this position first sitting on the floor. Starting position for the spin, inside hand is high, pulling down, and outside hand is between chest and belly height, pushing against the pole. First step away from the pole and turn facing the pole. Place the outside ankle on the pole, knee pointing to the side. To create momentum, lean in the direction in which your knee is pointing, away from the pole. Kick firmly with the standing leg to the back and keep it up until your hips touch the floor. Bottom hand keeps the pole away. Now do it fluently. A common mistake is to lean into the pole instead of away from the pole. You will lose the ankle contact point and you will swing back to the pole. Another common mistake is to keep the standing leg on the floor instead of kicking back, which will again cause losing the ankle grip. Practice on the second side. Instead of ending in a sitting position, you can step with your feet on the floor, keep pivoting in the same direction and place the first knee on the side of the pole. The second leg follows. Reach forward with your hands and lift your leg high, foot to head. To bring it to the other side of the pole, keep chest down and hips and knee as high as possible. Change legs. When your second leg is up, tilt your hips to the side and push the upper body into a sitting position. If done correctly, you should have both legs in a 90 degrees angle. Here's what it looks like from the side. Slide further in front of the pole and keep knees high to avoid kicking against the pole. The cross knee release may feel scary at first, but it's actually a very safe figure when you have a secure knee grip. Sit on the pole slightly above the floor and cross one leg on top of the other. Keep the bottom leg straight and muscles engaged. Pull belly in and lean slightly back. Pull with the opposite hand your ankle towards your hips until you feel your leg pressing against the pole. This is your main contact point. Your knee should be pointing to the side and there shouldn't be a gap between the pole and your knee. To test the grip of your legs, let go of the pole and hold in a crunched position. A conditioning exercise that will make your grip really solid are crunches. You can start with smaller crunches and slowly go lower with the upper body. A common mistake is to forget engaging the bottom leg. Keep it straight and pointing up to enhance the grip of the top leg. Try a bit higher on the pole. Move slowly through every step and make sure that you have a good grip before you go down with the upper body. Know that you can always crunch up and grab the pole if you don't feel safe. If you want to make it harder, you can try to release very slowly the hand grip of your ankle. Really squeeze your thighs together and make sure that your ankle remains close to your hips. Get comfortable in this position and play with your arms. Again, if you're sliding, check the tension of the bottom leg. This is especially important for the hands-free version of this move. To come out, crunch back up into pole sit. To add a rotation to your descent, bend the bottom leg and hook it on the pole. Draw a big long circle with the top leg and slide down until you can step on the floor. Keep pivoting in the same direction and push your hips up.
when you hold me and kiss me slowly, it's the sweetest thing. And it don't change. If I had it my way, you would know that you are. You're the coffee that I need in the morning. You're my sunshine in the rain when it's pouring. Won't you give yourself to me? Give it all. I just wanna see. I just wanna see how beautiful you are. You know that I see it. I know you're a star. Where you go, I'll follow. No matter how far. If life is a movie, oh, you're the best part. Oh, you're the best part. Oh, best part.
Let me know how this quick tutorial worked for you. Could you do almost from the choreography? Could you make it fluent and dance with the music? Don't forget to warm up in advance and download the warm-up video on thepoledancer.com/flowwarmup. See you soon!